How many tries does it take to write a smash? Well, in the case of the Neighbourhood, they managed with their first song, their breakout hit, Sweater Weather. But how did the band go about creating their first tune? And what is it about that song that resonated with so many people, both when it was first released and now with its recent resurgence on TikTok? Let's take a look back at how the Neighbourhood wrote Sweater Weather. She knows what I think about. In 2013, Californian alt-rockers The Neighbourhood burst onto the scene with their breakout song Sweater Weather. The indie rock earworm fused hip-hop beats with icy overdriven guitar licks and lush layered vocals and was a sleeper hit that gradually grew in success, eventually topping Billboard's alternative airplay chart. Pretty good going for the first song the band ever wrote. The Neighbourhood first formed in August 2011, with the band members meeting through the local music scene, but Sweater Weather precedes the band's official conception. All close friends before The Neighbourhood started, one day, pre-band formation, guitarist Zach Abels and vocalist Jesse Rutherford were working on music together, and Zach shared some guitar riffs he'd written.
I kind of wrote like the guitar parts, and like I showed Jesse one day, and Jesse did music, and he's like, oh man, like, you know, you gotta let me record you. Like,
well, you asked me to record it.
Yeah.
Because you were playing the riff a lot, and then you were like, hey, would you record this for me? And I was like, yeah, sure. And then I asked like, oh, well, can I do other stuff to it? And you're like, sure, I mean, I don't know what I want to do with it.
A few years later, Zach recalled this process of creating the song to radio.com, saying, Jesse said, of the guitar parts, hey, that's pretty cool, let me record that. And it just so happened to be Sweater Weather. When we got done writing the songs, when it was all said and done, we were like, okay, this is pretty good, we should keep writing songs. And that's exactly what they did. The band put an early demo of a song on Facebook, along with a handful of other tunes, and it quickly took off. Friends who live near started to hit them up, commenting on how good the song sounded.
I remember, not MySpace, but I think we put the song out on Facebook with like like three other songs.
An early demo though.
Yeah, like a really early demo of it. And then like other kids or other people, our friends were like hitting us up, like who live in our town and like around our town. And we're like, whoa, you know, you guys, sounds really sick. Like,
do you have a bass player?
Can I be in the band?
You have a drummer? Yeah.
The Neighbourhood, now officially formed, Sweater Weather received an official release in March 2012, and the buzz around the band began to grow. After dropping a handful of EPs, Sweater Weather then got a second release in March 2013 as the lead single for the band's debut album, I Love You, that dropped in April of that year. At this point, both the band and Sweater Weather started to really take off. There was a set at Coachella, a tour across the US, which included the 1975 as support on their first ever US tour, and live television performances. Receiving consistent radio play, in June of that year, Sweater Weather reached number one on the Billboard Alternative Airplay chart. Let me just take your breath away. I don't mind if there's not much to say. Sometimes the silence guides the mind to move to a place so far away. You can see why Sweater Weather resonated with so many people. The first verse, these hip-hop beats combined with peeling guitar riffs and Jesse Rutherford's distinctive vocals that sets up the depiction of intimacy that continues throughout the song. Coming down, one night. After the verse, Jesse then delivers a wordy pre-chorus, which feels like the song is building to a massive climactic peak. But it's a moment of deception, and everything begins to fade away. Catchy sing-along chorus and a unique blend of alt-rock and hip-hop, it's not hard to see why it took off in 2013, offering something a bit different to the huge pop hits that were dominating the radio waves. And it reached a new audience in 2020, experiencing a resurgence on TikTok. On the video sharing app, over 2 million videos have been created using the song, resulting in Sweater Weather becoming a smash with a whole new generation of listeners. The song's also become a bisexual anthem on TikTok, with users sharing clips of themselves accompanied by Sweater Weather or posting its lyrics as a way to identify themselves as part of the bisexual community. Since the release of Sweater Weather, The Neighbourhood have gone on to have a massive career, with global tours and three more albums, the last of which, Chip Chrome and the Monotones, was released last year. But they'll always have a place for this song in their hearts. As The Neighbourhood explained to NME in 2018, this song was the catalyst. after Sweat Weather, they wrote more songs, and it all started to fall into place.
Felt really good. It was just really fun.
Yeah, it was like, it felt good, and I think just kind of where we were all at that point in time in our lives. Like, I was just getting out of high school, you know, didn't know what I was going to do. I really didn't want to go to college.
And I knew exactly what I wanted to do, and then that song ended
and up. And that song happened, and then we wrote more songs, and yeah, just kind of all fell into place.